Much ado and controversy has developed over the newly discovered interstellar object 3I Atlas since its discovery, and the good news is that we now know a lot more about this object than we did even a week ago. I want to be clear here because there have been many claims regarding a potential alien technological origin as a result of a thought experiment paper, and then the idea rapidly spun out of control into sensationalism and incorrect information. The reality is that this object is a comet of interstellar origin that was ejected from another star system. So here is what we know. Very recently, the Hubble Space Telescope observed the object and basically ended the controversy over the object's nature. If it had been an asteroid and not a comet, it would have had to have been improbably large based on its brightness. The reason is a matter of odds. The universe likes small objects over large ones. You are more likely to see a million grains of sand as you walk across the beach than you are a large rock. Large rocks happen, but you're going to see way more grains of sand before you see the rock, chances are. That holds for everything. Small stars like red dwarfs are far more common than supergiant stars. Dust is more common than asteroids and so on. Massive things are rare in the universe. But a comet with a coma is deceptive. The actual nucleus of the comet can be very tiny, a few kilometers or far less, but still project out a huge coma that reflects more light and looks much larger than it actually is. It's outgassing dust and gas. This is simply an effect of warming up volatile ices with increasing sunlight. So the comet forms a coma and then a tail, and then it gets brighter and more evident the closer it approaches the warmth of a star. That flashing to gas blows dust out of the comet, and both together form the tail. The alien aspect would have come in if the object had been a giant asteroid, since you should see many, many smaller interstellar objects before you see a very large one like this. Given that this is the third confirmed interstellar object we've seen, it's very improbable to have spotted a giant asteroid this early in the game. That in turn raises the chances that the object could be artificial in nature, but only if it had been an asteroid. This led Avi Loeb to co-author a paper presenting a thought experiment of what scenarios might play out had it been artificial. In the paper, however, the authors very clearly state that they believed that it was overwhelmingly likely that this object would turn out to be a harmless, natural comet, and that the paper was a thought experiment intended to provoke thought in just what an alien entrance into our solar system would look like with 3I Atlas as a guide. Interesting idea, but a dead one since this is an interstellar comet. The actual size of the nucleus of the comet is not well constrained, but best estimates right now are about a kilometer wide to as much as 11 kilometers. This is interesting because even at 1 kilometer, it's still twice the size of Comet Borisov, which was the second discovered interstellar object, but very much well within normal for a comet, but actually in line with solar system comets like Halley, which was about 11 kilometers by 8 kilometers. As an interesting aside, after the discovery of the object by the Atlas team, astronomers searched the data and there were actually a number of observations previous to it that caught the comet, but did not recognize it. However, if the Vera Rubin telescope had begun its science validation tests 2 weeks before it did, it would have discovered it even earlier. There's a good reason to be excited about that telescope, because it's going to spot interstellar objects often and early when it begins its main science survey mission. In addition to the coma, there is now additional evidence corroborating the cometary nature in the form of a detection of water ice in the coma, which is quite normal for a comet. There will be links to all referenced papers in the description below. But there was also a paper by Marcos and colleagues that noted that comets further than 4 AU from the Sun do not show the full profile of gas sublimation until they get closer in, just water initially. This was one of the claims floating around, that the object was not comet-like because it was not outgassing the other types of ices normally seen in a comet. In reality, it's not supposed to show them this early, and no comets do. But you can expect such emissions to develop as the object gets closer to the Sun. The comet is also showing a diffuse tail, and when studied in different wavelengths of light, the absorption of light changes, indicating dust, and that dust is reddened, which is consistent with a comet. Indeed, Borisov showed this. Observations done in the Canary Islands showed that the nucleus has a rotation rate of just under 17 hours and varies in brightness as it rotates, which is to be expected. The accidental early images of 3I Atlas, done by Vera Rubin but unrecognized until after the discovery, shows that the comet's nucleus has grown, also perfectly normal for a comet. And now for a common question I get regarding this object. Will the James Webb Space Telescope be looking at it? And the answer is very much a yes, and there will be more with Hubble. So far, this is what NASA has planned for the telescopes. Hubble, as I mentioned, already imaged the object earlier this month. This is the image. But in November, Hubble will perform ultraviolet spectroscopy on the comet to look at gas emissions and its sulfur to oxygen ratio. It will then further monitor the object on its way out of the solar system. James Webb will make an observation in August, before the comet's perihelion, or closest approach to the sun, and then again in December to look at it after its closest approach. It will be looking in infrared to detect compounds like ammonia, water, carbon dioxide, and carbon monoxide, as well as take images. So far, pretty normal for a comet as it turns out. However, there is one unusual aspect about this comet that makes it of particular interest. It's significantly older than the solar system. At 7 billion years old and being from the thick galactic disk, which is full of old stars, this object offers us a look at what comet formation looked like 2.5 billion years before the solar system formed, and specifically look at differences in composition and ratios to our own solar system comets. Not only is this a peek at another star system, it's also a peek back in time at a significantly younger Milky Way, from a population of stars different in composition to the Sun and the solar system. Another aspect of this is by getting a profile of ancient comets like this, hopefully we will see more of them quickly, and that would give a window into what early comets were delivering to the exoplanets 7 billion years ago. And it pays to remember, comets contain organics, the building blocks of life, including amino acids, and very likely played a role in delivering the stuff of life to the planets of the universe, including Earth. And now for another interesting update. The sheer speed of this object, which incidentally is an indicator of its great age, precludes anything we could launch to be able to catch up with it for close observation. Indeed, the window to intercept it head-on actually passed a full year before we even discovered the object. There is the possibility that at its closest approach, when it will be behind the sun from our perspective, we won't get to see that here, the Mars probes could observe it, as it's expected to be about 11th magnitude, and by then, they can detect that, giving us a perhaps imperfect but still valid view of 3I Atlas's closest approach and brightest period. But there's now another option. In a paper by Atsuhiro Yaginuma and colleagues, they found that while you can't launch a feasible intercept mission from Earth, you can launch one from Mars. Obviously, we do not have a Cape Canaveral on Mars, where we could send up a rocket. But we may not actually need a service-launched rocket to do this. Rather, one of the Mars probes nearing the end of its intended mission could do it if it has enough fuel left to fire its onboard rockets. The idea of intercepting a comet is something we've already done, intercepting Halley's Comet in the 1980s and snapping a photo of its nucleus. And we've even done sample returns from comets. This could easily be done with an interstellar comet as well, if we can catch it. The problem is timing and speed, not the ability to study one up close as far as the instrumentation and capabilities are concerned. This may change soon. ESA has approved a mission called Comet Interceptor, which has a flexible mission plan from the start and involves not just one spacecraft, but several. The idea is to be ready and in space to catch a pristine solar system comet at its first pass ever to the sun and study it. And there's talk about a dedicated interstellar object mission that would be launched and in space ready to respond and intercept when one is detected. As to Mars, however, the spacecraft currently nearing the end of their mission lifetimes include Mars Odyssey, Mars Express, Maven, Mars Reconnaissance Orbiter, and the ExoMars Trace Gas Orbiter, all of which have imaging and instrumentation that can be used for a flyby of 3I Atlas around its closest approach to Mars. There is a history of doing this. Cassini, for example, was deorbited, partly to prevent it from contaminating any of the moons of Saturn, but also to get really close-up measurements of Saturn, which was a success, before it plunged into the planet and burned up. This would be in addition to other spacecraft imaging the comet from Mars orbit, and even probes in the solar system like OSIRIS-APEX that can do meaningful observations from afar. It's going to be an interesting end of year indeed. Thanks for listening. I am futurist and science fiction author John Michael Godier, currently advocating that someone make a welcome sign and point it in the general direction of 3i Atlas. One does not cold shoulder the dinner guest and just stare at it silently just because it turned out to be a comet. There's no reason to be rude, and let's face it, it's probably a good thing because with an interstellar spacecraft, you may well end up as the dinner. And be sure to check out my books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channels for regular in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspect of this amazing universe in which we live.